Hi everyone, in this introductory video I'm going to explain what a control system is and why we need them. So let's begin by imagining we have a large tank of some sort of catalyst near a heat source, like a boiler. If the tank's temperature exceeds 50 degrees C, the catalyst will denature and is now essentially worthless. Well, obviously we're going to want some way of cooling our storage tank to prevent the catalyst from getting destroyed. So, to ensure our tank never exceeds 50 degrees C, we're going to want some way of controlling the cooling system for our catalyst tank. Let's just say that our ideal storage temperature for the catalyst is 40 degrees Celsius. Well, we can achieve this desired temperature through the use of a control system. So let's talk about what exactly a control system is. A control system is a set of devices that we can control, such as opening or closing a valve, in a system which is designed to maintain a given condition despite disturbances in a dynamic or changing system. The set point is the condition that we want our desired variable to reach. So, in our previous example, that is our 40 degrees Celsius tank temperature. Disturbances are things that affect our system, but we cannot control them directly within our system. So, this would be like the heat radiating from the boiler. We typically represent control systems using block diagrams. So let's create a control system using a simple block diagram. Our inputs to the control system will be our manipulated variables. These are the things that we can control, like the coolant flow rate around the tank. And our disturbances are things that we cannot control, like the radiant energy emitted by the boiler. At the output, we will have our desired temperature, which we said was 40 degrees Celsius. Obviously, control systems are more complex than this, and we will work our way up to that in future videos. However, I just want you to recognize that a control system is about achieving a desired result, despite disturbances. So before implementing our new control system, let's say the temperature profile looks something like this. After implementing our control system, we can minimize the temperature variance and save our company significant money, improve the safety of our plant, and ensure that our product, whatever it is always consistent to our consumers. So, in summary, a control system is a way for us to regulate or control a given process, whatever that may be, and that is what this playlist will focus on. Our control system could be something relatively simple, like a SISO, which means single input, single output, so this could be like a water level in the bucket under a sink, versus a more complicated multi-input, multi-output, a MIMO, which for example could be like controlling the tank's temperature, pressure, and level of water in the tank. Thank you for checking out the video. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in the video, leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.